AFFiNE Pro. It's a brand new visual note-taking application which sort of combines Notion and Miro. Well, that's at least how they're marketing it. And in today's video, we're going to overview what it does, how it works, and whether it's worth your time to check out as a note-taking experience. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesco. If you're new here to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, do subscribe. It would be lovely to have you as a subscriber, so do consider it below. And if you're in the hunt for any tools, maybe you watch this video and you want to learn more about AFFiNE Pro, or you want to learn about any visual note taker, you can go over to Toolfinder and hunt for any productivity tools there. And we've got a brand new newsletter that dives into the newest productivity apps. Everything will be linked below. So if you need anything, including the app that we reviewed today, find it there. So this is AFFiNE Pro. And first of all, I thought it was an Italian company. AFFiNE. I thought it was. I genuinely was like, okay, this is an Italian company. It's got to be. But it's actually a Japanese-based company. So it couldn't be farther from Italy. And you can see here, it's trying to combine the likes of writing, drawing, and planning with AI. And it's trying to be part of two markets, the team market and the individual market. And it's got quite a lot of stuff going on with it. And they've touted themselves as Notion with Miro, which I think it's actually Craft with Miro, which is a documents-based application combining with Miro, which is a whiteboarding application. And I actually chatted with the team probably about 2 months ago. He went through the product with me. I'd rarely do this, but for an application like this, I was so curious about what was behind the motivation behind the company, because it's a very different concept. And I wanted to sort of dig a bit deeper. And one thing I was very impressed by was how they did whiteboards. So we'll dive into that in a moment. So it is offline, open source, local, which is good. And it is available for teams as well. This is what it looks like. It's available on Mac. And there are sort of three features I want to talk about. Documents or pages, whiteboards, and the journaling, which I'll talk about near the end. So here is how you create a new page. And okay, what's this? I can scroll between two views. One is called edgeless mode and one's called page mode. Now, if I, for example, wanted to create a note, I could go ahead and start typing the regular stuff, a note. And I could press slash command to find any of the relevant stuff like content media, databases, and actions and things like that. Styling, multimedia, things you'd expect to be inside of an application. And the one thing I can do is add databases. I want to show you this first because they call it Notion versus Notion and Miro, but I call it Craft versus Miro. And the main reason is because whilst the databases they have are functional, they're nowhere near the level of Notion. I can understand why they did obviously bring it together because of the allure of the way it looks in this application. But this is their table view. And very simply, I can add an item, can change the title, I can change the status, change the column type to anything from progression, all the way to multi-select, and I can create them, and I can add new columns, I could add a new record, and I could use some basic properties, filters, grouping, and I believe they have sorting too. I don't think they have sorting. I'm not sure whether they have sorting. Yes, they do. Do they? I don't think they do have sorting. So again, what you're getting here is a much, much, much lighter version of databases in Notion. And I'm not going to sort of bore you with the databases too much because I don't think it's the real source inside of AFFiNE Pro. And it's Kanban view is also available, so I can move stuff across. And what you'd expect with a Kanban view, you've got some of the basic properties, filters, grouping, and you can add an additional view as well. I can rename this a board. So you can start to get the idea of how it works. It's very simple in terms of its nature, which is good. Something that you want maybe to start interacting with. But this is where it gets a bit more magical, and this is where I was more impressed. The page view can turn into edgeless mode. And if I go up here, I can see there that my page is already turning into a edgeless mode experience. Now, the real magic is where I can go ahead and add a block in, maybe even type like hello, and I'm just keeping this as a basic demonstration. So this is showing only in Edgeless. So if I go over to my page, it's not showing there because you can choose where it shows in both or in page only or in Edgeless only. And this is really nice because it separates the visual functionality. So that was one of the things for me that really impressed me from day one, because they've seemed to have got the conceptualization of between the difference in whiteboard and pages. It could be a real mess if it was the other way around. Now, the other thing that I liked is, for example, I'm just doing this as demonstration purposes, just chuck a couple of shapes in there, maybe some text here. Oh, I can use a pen, there we go, blah, 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 blah. And throw an image in there of this smudge mark on a tablet. Oh, I've still got the pen activated. Stop pen. I think I've still got the pen activated. Oh, there, I've got to press the select. and let me get rid of a few of these lines because it's going to ruin my demonstration. And finally, I'm going to chuck an image of a cat in, which you can do to demonstrate stuff. The cat should be appearing somewhere. Did I press it? I didn't press it. Oh, I did. It just took a little bit of a lag. So let's say I'm doing a presentation about cats and what they did to this smudge mark. There's going to be a point to all of this, I promise. I was most impressed by this feature. Drag over it and you're like, okay, this is grouping, Francesco. It's not. You can group it. Framing. Framing is probably the most powerful feature, sort of like a screenshot. And if I press insert into page, it will link it. So if I go back over here, scroll down, bam. Really neat visualization tool. And the reason why that's so powerful is for two reasons. Because in-page demonstrations are hard to do. You're always adding screenshots. You're always trying to add context visually. And having those two in there is so nice. So you can have these screenshot type things. And the second thing is, if I hypothetically made a second one with this element, and I'm just really just trying to demonstrate quite fast. If I demonstrate frame two and insert into page, yes, I've got it there. I can go back to it if I want to. I can actually have it so that I can choose the framing section, etc. The real magic is where I can turn it into a presentation. So if I go out of, make it smaller view, I can have a presentation here. I can hide the, there we go. I can make it look a little bit neater. And this way I'm like, right, I'm in a presentation mode. Let me just, sorry, I screwed up again. There we go. I can scrabble through and be like, whoa, here's my presentation. And I'm doing little effort, but I'm quickly converting. Let me know in the comments if this is available feature in Miro, because I've missed that big time. but I love that. I love that ability to quickly sort of scrabble between stuff. And I can still zoom out outside a page and still go into the content. And I can go ahead and modify information here, which is really nice. So this is one of the things that I've most liked about it. You do get a way to, for example, I can bring in some to-dos and things like that. I can also add in things like brainstorming, like a SWOT analysis, which I should have remembered what it is: strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. I did go to business school, I promise. I've just created a giant shape. But you can start to see how helpful this is in terms of being able to visualize stuff. Some of the stuff they didn't get quite right. Like, I feel like some of the templates are half-baked, but I think they wanted to get this out fairly fast. You can scrabble through more of these and sort of visualize some of the other ones. You can use an eraser, text, images. You can use connections between things. And if I wanted to, like hypothetically, I could frame this one. And I didn't press insert into page. If I go over to the note, there we go. I got a SWOT analysis nice and easy in here. And I can even go into the page straight away. Some of the stuff is a little bit difficult. I feel like there's some loose bugs around, but largely I've been impressed with how they've been able to visualize that. That's one of the most difficult things, I think, in whiteboard and that space. So you can view stuff in pages, collections, which is basically folders. And in settings, you can change some of the other stuff. There is some pricing plans. Am I on Pro? I don't know whether I'm on Pro. I could be on Pro. I normally ask for Pro in my account to be able to get things set up, but this is the pricing for Pro, $7.99. But with the zero pricing, with the zero per month pricing, it's unlimited login, limited local. You can have a number of members, three members per workspace, which is pretty good. So that's pretty good. And you can collaborate with other people is the sort of real digger. They've also got the ability to use this as your journal as well, which is really nice. So I could, for example, start tallying away some thoughts and notes. And whenever I'm on a page, I can always see what's been created today or what's been updated today, which is a real neat one. So overall, I am very impressed by this application, primarily because it does a few things differently. Those are open source, local, offline, secure, and the whiteboard abilities. Those are the most important things that separate it from other applications. It's no Notion. It's maybe even no Craft, but I feel like it's Craft with Miro is probably the closest comparison. Now, if you're curious at whether this application is right for you, there are a bunch of these visual note takers popping up everywhere. Most recently, and most interestingly, Craft is looking to add whiteboards, I believe, from a couple of tweets that I saw. So at the same time, these applications, these note-taking applications, are realizing they need this visual canvas element to be able to enhance it. And I think that's rapidly coming true. Now, I have been playing around with this quite a while, but actually they had a product hunt release today. Saw it and it was like, I probably need to get to this one. But they are seemingly out in the wild now with this application. So it's really nice. The onboarding is super lovely if you haven't tried it yet. Not saying that's the reason to get this application, but very interesting to say the least. So folks, I hoped that you did enjoy this feature. If you are new here to the channel, do subscribe. If you want to find productivity tools, you know where to go. And finally, I will see you in a future video if you're hunting for more productivity tools. So thank you very much and cheerio.